These are demonstrations on the steps of the Supreme Court this morning. The justices right now are hearing arguments on President Trump's decision to end DACA protections. The Obama-era program protects undocumented immigrants who came to the U.S. as children, protects them from deportation. President Trump issued an executive order to end those protections in 2017. Lower courts, however, kept them in place. The fate of those 700,000 people under that program now remain in limbo. Joining me now is Todd Schulte. He's president of FWD US, a bipartisan group focused on fixing the immigration system. Todd also recently went to the border, and we're going to show you some of the things he found there. But first on this DACA question, Todd, because this is something that you cover very closely here. The court is considering the Trump decision here to end the Obama administration program, but central to their decision-making here is how Trump ended that program. Can you explain to our viewers what that is and how it's relevant?
Yeah, that's right. DACA has been a transformative program for about 700,000 young Americans who came to this country at the average age of 6 and have been here for over 20 years. And what the Supreme Court is hearing is, you know, the manner in which the president unlawfully ended the program. And a number of federal courts have said a president does have the theoretical right to end this program, but the way in which this administration, led by Attorney General Sessions, went through with it was unlawful, and multiple federal courts have said that's the case.
And that's because in the meeting where the decision was made, no rationale was given. Is that right? It was just kind of a one-line thing saying, we're ending this, yeah. And that therefore undermines their legal argument?
Well, they stood up and they said, we're getting rid of it because it's unconstitutional and it's illegal. And in fact, DACA has been around at that point for 5 years. It's been around for 7 years now. It is legal. So you can't just arbitrarily and capriciously right. end a program. So they went about this in the wrong way, and multiple federal judges have said that's the case.
Okay. Now in the court, will the Trump administration be given a mulligan, as it were, here and given an opportunity to give another rationale and say, hey, forget what we said about that before. This is why we really ended the program.
Well, I think if you look at the support for the program, 85% of the public thinks Dreamers should stay in this country. Yeah. The lawyer who's arguing today, Ted Olson, was actually George W. Bush's Solicitor General. You have the United States Chamber of Commerce in support of this program. This program's been a huge win. And ending this program would be truly devastating. I mean, you'd lose the ability for 700,000 young people to live and work legally in this country. So we're really confident we're going to win today at the Supreme Court.
Okay, let's talk about something else, because you went down to the border where you found, I mean, just a fact that I don't think most folks are aware of, that the asylum system for taking in people claiming suffering or in danger to their life at home has virtually come to a stop. And now these camps have developed on the Mexico side of the border. Tell us what you saw there and why this is happening.
Yeah, so if you think back to 2018, you saw the family separation crisis, and this was really the first assault on the asylum system that got national attention. What you have seen subsequently is a series of interlocking policies that are really designed to essentially end the entire asylum system in the U.S.-Mexico border. This is at a time when unauthorized crossings have plummeted historically. But what you are seeing here is essentially a tent camp in Matamoros, directly across from Brownsville. And what you can see on those visuals is awful. The conditions are terrible. It is the result of U.S. policy, and it is about 3,000 people. That's up from 500 people only 2 months ago, who are living in camps feet, I mean, 3, 10, 25 feet from the border, because they were too scared to go inland into Mexico, because these are incredibly dangerous places. But we are sending women and children there to wait for months or potentially ever before they get a fair asylum hearing.
Well, those pictures you showed, we show them again to tell a story here, and I think it's a phenomenon that most Americans aren't aware is happening down there. Todd Schulte, thanks very much.
Thanks for having me.